Okay, mainly to the fact that these antibiotics are making me feel a little bit better than I have been over the last few months. So, yeah, you may ask what I've got on the screen. What I've got on the screen could actually be proof that Barack Obama was born in Kenya. A footprint is the same as a thumbprint. It actually contains certain things within the print that even at birth will still be the same at an older age, i.e. prints don't change, whether it's a young print or an old print. There are certain identifying markers, even just in that one there, I can actually see an identifying marker. Where are we? Yeah, just here. Like, I've got to admit, this image wouldn't be the one, but his actual true birth certificate would be. Because what we have here, okay, he's also could be done for fraudulent perjury, false identity. Here he is, his name's Barry Soretto. He has no record of actually ever changing his name to Barack Obama. He may have been born as Barack Obama, but his name was changed to Barry Soretto. So, hence, legally, he is still Barry Soretto and was a foreign student. He was born in Kenya. His mother may have come from Hawaii, but I can guarantee you he did not. See, unlike the mainstream media, the civilians out there that do videos and things like that, and people like myself, we actually research stuff. We go online, we do searches, and let's just see if I've still got that search up. Yep, there we go. And here we go. Here is the Barack Obama birth certificate, right? His real birth certificate. Now, see, the thing is, when you're in the Commonwealth, we've got what we call the birth, deaths, and marriages. No matter where in the Commonwealth it is, it's called birth, deaths, and marriages. Okay? The coast of province of Kenya, right, hereby certifies this is a true copy of the entry in the birth register of the province book of da 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 da. Now, if you make a simple phone call to Kenya, you will actually find out that that is actually a real birth certificate. And looking at the format of it and everything like that, that's actually pretty much what my birth certificate looks like, but with different details. Mine says Australia. The way it's folded up, it's almost bloody identical to mine, because I folded mine up and did the same mistake instead of keeping it pristine. I actually have a new pristine copy of it. But see this here, this embossing? That's a genuine embossing. You can look it up. Okay, now the typing is all in the correct place and everything like this. He was born actually in the... same year as me, actually. No. Yeah, he was too. He was born the same year as me. Couple of months older than me, actually. Not by much, but yeah. The thing is, doesn't matter what you do, you look at it, just do some research. All you got to do is actually just go in to Google. Just type in Obama's Kenyan birth certificate. And you'll actually find out that his mother and father, there's what we call extracts and things like that. This is what you call an extract, right there. Right, that's an extract. Right, that's that other one next to it is a full birth certificate. Right, so we've got what we call extracts, which is that one. And this one, which is a full birth certificate. And there's the, and in the extract, it's pretty much from the hospital where they put the print of your foot onto the document, which is pretty much legalizing you as that person, even at that age. They fingerprint you or footprint you. Ah, get that footprint. Ah, funny. So, here we go, Barry Sorrento. Yes, you were born Barack Obama, but your name was changed to Barry Sorrento. And there are actual plenty of documentation. Just go through these documents. Do what I did. You can run through them. Unlike the... Where are we? Unlike this one, which is a fake. Everybody knows it's a fake. You've only got to look at the typesets and everything like that. And the simple thing that you go through and everything like that, you find that this has massive layers, right? If you can still get the original one, you'll see it. I don't know where mine is. I did actually save it. I do have it on this particular computer even, right? And the whole thing is, right, you've got to turn around, you've got to look at your documentation. That, I can guarantee you, that there is a genuine document. And I'm going to jump to the previous because I've actually got a better picture of it. Okay, here we go here. There's his, or his certificate of birth, sorry, not the extract. It's a certificate of birth. I've mixed that one up. You can get an extract as well, which is similar to this one, but which is generally what you get when you're born anyhow. Right, now, see, weight of child, right here, 7 pounds. Residence of mother, right? Honolulu was his mother's residence, right? So they're pretty much going by the fact that there wasn't many records in that time. But see here, that alone could be compared to his modern day footprint, and they would still be able to extract certain images and say, yes, that's similar, right? But you look at this and you go right through this whole document and you can tell that there's no forgery within this document. This is genuine. You go right through, same typewriter, a typical typewriter mistake right there, right, where the key has been struck twice or they've moved it back, and everything. That is a standard typewriter mistake. Trust me, I come from an age of typewriters when typewriters, before it was your word processor, right? Unlike, and his, see, his original, right, his original, this one here, would have been done with the same typewriter, right? Not 7 or 8 typewriters, because no matter what you do, when you go through this image, you will actually see different typesets of the typewriter alone, right? That tells you this is a fake, right? And it's those typesets within the document and everything like that. It's already been proven that it is a fake, right? And his real birth certificate, there's Obama's real birth certificate. Born on the 10th of A, oh, okay, date and place of birth. Okay, he's a bit older than me. Okay, so, what is it? Is that the right one? Ah, shit, I've downloaded the wrong one. Ha, sorry, folks. Yes, that's my mistake. That's my mistake. I'm very sorry. I downloaded the wrong birth certificate. There we go. There's a shot of Barack Obama's birth certificate, 4th of August, 1961. Right, same typeset right throughout the whole document. I must have actually accidentally downloaded that guy's as well, thinking it was Barack Obama's. But yeah, there are better copies of it, and I'll try and find it, because I wasn't watching what I was doing. I've just clicked on the image thinking it was the the correct one. So we're going to save that. So I've just seen a flat one, and I thought it was the same one, seeing it was on the same page as Barack Obama's. Get that one. Right. It's the same birth certificate, folks. It really is. So see some handwritten. All documents are all similar. They've got different things to them, and that's an Australian military forces document. Don't know what it's doing actually in here. But you go through the documentation. Notice how they're all the typewriters, the same typeset. They don't take it out of one typewriter and put it into another. Right? No matter what you do, right? You go through the document and you look at it. Okay, Barack Obama the second. Right? Barack Hussein Obama, 20 years old. And that's where he's thinking. He's a student. His mother, Stanley Ann Obama, formerly Duran, right? Because you had to put your maiden name in Commonwealth documents. You've actually got to list your maiden name. And you go through and you look at everything and signature and do thing. And it says that they were living in Honolulu at the time of his birth. Now, typical of Commonwealth documents. You go in the day after your child is born, and it looks like his father is the one that did the registration of it. And that's pretty generally what happens. Like, I'm on my children's documents, the ones that are still around. And it's always the day after. I don't know anybody that goes in on the same day. But you've got to register your child. It's the law in the Commonwealth. You've got to actually do it. And the whole thing is, you go right through the whole documents, but it's the Barry Soretto one. See, there's a lot of documents on Barack Obama, right? Tons and tons of documentation on Barack Obama. It doesn't matter what you click on, and you can get these documents for yourself. Okay, you just got to simply go in, click on the document, and you get the document. All right, there's his footprint, and you go right through. What's this one? Is this Barracks? I don't know. I don't know if that's Barracks. Nah, it's just showing you that's a birth certificate. I think that's an Australian birth certificate. Yeah, actually, it might be an Australian one because it's got the red one on it. Because in Australia, we use a red embossing in our country. Yeah, compared to this one of... No. Kenya, birthplace of Barack Obama. Well, why would they be saying it's birthplace of Barack Obama? There's so many flaws in Barack Obama's birth certificate that it is beyond a joke, an absolute joke. There are so many typesets, so many parts of this document have been changed. And you've only got to review the footage, go through them, and look at them, and look at all the different people and everything, and you will actually find, here, Kenyan born, there we go. Kenyan-born U.S. Senate hopeful Barack Obama appeared set to take over Illinois' Senate seat. Kenyan-born. Back then, he wasn't running for president, and they declared him Kenyan-born. So any idiot out there, like Barack Obama, dead set, should be arrested, locked up. See, when he comes out of power, I bet you the day the arsehole is going to be dumb enough to say, I beat the system. I'm a Kenyan and I was president, and everybody should, any American citizen should be able to become president. I did. I bet you this prick is dumb enough to come out and say something like that. Because he's an idiot, number one. And like this guy here proved that the thing was definitely a fraud. They've gone through, they've noticed all the faults in the document. And as I said, there are so many documents out there that prove that he was not born in America. He was born in a British thing called Kenya. And you go right through, you look at it, and this is his stepdad, Soretto. This is where his name was changed to Soretto. And you go right through and you look at everything and you look at all the different parts and everything like that. He hasn't presented any, like, education documents. He's withheld everything. Why has he withheld everything? Because he's fucking lying. Right, so you got to understand this, folks. You have got a president that gained power, he lied to get into power, and the whole thing is this guy is full of shit. He's been full of shit from number one. He's been proven to have the wrong social security number connected to different things. I'm not going to accuse him of anything, but there are videos out there saying that his social security number is connected to a fraud case and is connected to somebody that's not Barack Obama. So to me, that says that's wrong, right? Here, sealed until after November 4th. Why? No Obama, right? The whole thing is, right, no matter where you look, right, you go through and you look at everything and, right, you find the evidence. That's all I did. I just went through and found evidence. And you look at all these different things and just go out and see and look for the evidence for yourself. You're going to find out your president, not Trump's an American citizen. Was born there. But this guy, full of shit. He's Kenyan born. Just because his mum was born in Honolulu, they've lied and paid somebody. He's used the taxpayers' money most probably to forge this document. And, oh, there we go. Right, this is what you call layers, right? Bang, 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 bang. And when you go through the document in Photoshop, you find all these layers appear. Right, this looks like it's somebody in Germany that's actually done this, because we've got German up there. And so even people in Germany have been trying to divulge this document. Why? Because it's a fake. Anybody that's done any digital processing of images and has worked with Photoshop only has to open up this one that was on the website, and it comes up in layers. You see the fakes, you see the cover-ups, you see the whiteness and the feathering and everything like that. Obama is a liar, right? If he was in my country, I would be, and this was our rule and everything like that, I would be doing everything in my power to make sure this guy was impeached. If I was an American, I'd be fighting to impeach this lying prick. And I tell you now, you should make the moment he's out of his presidency, which is only a couple of months down the road. See, this is the whole reason, see. Soros knows that his little puppet, right, wasn't legit, right? And he wasn't born a Brit, he was born a Kenyan. And but yes, it's British, but he's still born a Kenyan. Just because he's part of born in the Commonwealth doesn't mean he's actually British. He is a Kenyan, not British. He was born in the British Commonwealth, but it doesn't make him a Brit. All right, so those of you out there that have said that, well, yeah, you might need to do a little bit of research on that. So go through and look at everything and you will find that your president is full of shit. Full of shit, big liar. There's your real president there, right? Donald Trump, that's your real president. Elected, born in America. And yeah, the mainstream media has lied to you for years. Why? Because they're run by George Soros. Soros is the real person behind the media. And you've only got to bloody look at the evidence. Do your own fucking research. If you don't do your own research, you're a fucking idiot. You really are. I've got to say it, you are. To those Hillary supporters out there that are going, Hillary lost, go out and do your fucking research. You'll find that she is, one, Satan worshipper, pedophile herself, right? Look at the things, look what they found, right? They've used their money to buy corrupt people, pay them off, because corruption is what half of these governments are bloody all about, right? They pay off these people that don't have a red razu. God, I know people would bend over backwards to be corrupt for $5,000. Everybody's got a price, and that's the problem. Everybody's got, well, most people have got a price, I don't. But the thing is, you've got to turn around and you've got to look at the shit that goes on, right? And you've got to, like, this is what was done. They've covered over stuff, they've cut it out, blanked it, and then they've put their own information over it. Looks like it was a real birth certificate. Looks like it might have been similar, or they've got one that's had different information on it and they've doctored it. Most probably paid someone that was born in the hospital on the day, and then they've just thrown their own information in there, right? Not hard to do with electronics these days. It's bloody dead easy. See, what they've done, a marriage in here and it made it look like it's real. But it's not fucking real, folks. It's bullshit. Barack Obama is a lying asshole, right? I can guarantee if he tries to hide here, he won't last long in Australia because everybody will be after the bastard. No one here has ever liked him. But the whole thing is, you've got to turn around and you've got to start doing your own research, folks. Wake up. Wake the fuck up. Your president, ex-president, oh, hang on, no, he's still your president, all right? But by the time somebody watches this, he'll be ex. So you want to turn around and impeach this prick. He's a lying arsehole. Yeah, okay, so what, he was the first black president and they tried to make Hillary the first female president, right? This is all part of the New World fucking order, right? They're fucking arseholes. It's all written in the Bible. They've planned this for fucking years. They've most probably been planning how to overthrow the world and make the world one fucking world government. Because see, you want to know why they want one world government? So the one fucking family that sits behind everything can rule the fucking world. So they can tell you what you can do, what you can't fucking do. See, they don't want you to have fucking freedom. They don't. You just think you have freedom, right? See, effectively, you're all slaves. You just don't realize it. You are a slave. If you work for the man, you're a slave, right? You work for anybody, you're a slave. The only difference is they give you a wage so that you can go away and say, well, I earned that. That's my money. But it's not. They're just giving you your food money, your rent money, and everything like that. Then they put you into debt, so you got to pay off your debt. See, if you're in debt, you're a more controllable citizen because you're freaking out and wondering, oh, fuck, I've got to pay that bill, I've got to pay that bill, or, oh, no, I know. See, money's fucking full of shit. Money is full of shit. Unless you are self-sufficient, got everything you fucking need, money's full of shit. Yes, it buys your groceries because it's the currency of the land. Right, it's not a silver coin like it used to be. They've turned made paper more fucking valuable than solid gold. And it effectively is. Pound for pound, money's actually worth more than gold. That's all they've done. Why? Because they don't have enough gold to share around. See, without money, they wouldn't have fucking power. So this is why you've got to wake up. You've got to wake the fuck up. So what? You owe a debt. So fucking what? Don't fucking worry about it. Don't fucking stress out it over it. Pay it off at $5 a week. You know, when I was in debt, that's what I did. Since then, I've never had fucking... I don't use credit. I use my own cash. I actually save my cash now. Do you know that you can accumulate just as much money and actually still buy stuff that you need without going into debt? And it costs you less because you're not paying fucking interest. It takes you longer to buy that first purchase. And when you bought that item, just keep on fucking saving. I stick equivalent to $300 a week in the bank. Without fucking fail. When I need something, the money's there. See, they don't want you to save. That's why they gave up all the interest on a fucking bank account. That's why they charge you fucking fees. Because they want the people that are fucking saving money to lose their fucking money in savings. Some smart people don't even use fucking banks. In a way, they're dumb because they're up to robbery and shit like that. But I'd sooner lose a few bucks than fucking worry about anything. But the whole thing is, you don't need to fucking worry about all this shit. The moment you do, you get conned by crap like this. The mainstream media are fucking liars. Nothing more than fucking lies. They've been lying to you all your life. Why? Because it's propaganda so that they can rule the fucking world. Right? See, the longer you are in fear, right, you will jump through fucking hoops. You will worship pricks like this. Like, I watched a video today, like, on Obama's fucking, like, a cavalcade of Obama. Like, people are lining up fucking the streets just to see Obama fucking drive past. They can't even see it. All they see is a car. Fuck me. You wouldn't catch me out in the street trying to see a fucking queen or nothing. I couldn't give a fuck. Oh, yeah, fair enough. I've gone to see bands when I was younger. But I didn't really go to see the bands after the time. I only went to get fucking drunk. Well, I remember going to see the Angels. I wound up on the ground drunk as a skunk. Never saw the fucking band. Can't even remember. I went to see another band. Midnight Oil, I think it was. Same thing fucking happened. Wound up drunk as a skunk. Didn't even see the fucking band. Back in those days, it was the only way I could get drunk. I got my sister snuck me out. I'll pinch all their alcohol and get drunk. But the whole thing is, folks, don't be fucking lied to, right? See, people have been protesting. They've had the evidence out there, but the problem is half of the dumb fucks out there, and I'm calling them dumb fucks because they believe the mainstream fucking media, right? If you believe the mainstream media, you are a fucking dropkick. Now, in Australia, a dropkick is what we call a fucking idiot. Because their brains have been dropped on the ground and drop-kicked fucking miles away. So we call them drop-kicks. Because they've got no fucking brains. Because it's been kicked away. So you've got to ask yourself, are you a drop-kick? Or are you someone that's going to stand up and fucking impeach your fucking current president who needs fucking impeaching? Right? Now, this is to all the little school kid fucking protesters out there. And I don't care whether you're a subscriber of mine or not. Right? If you are one of those crybaby fucking protesters out there at the moment, you are being led by little sheeps. Fair enough. Yeah, you're getting paid by Soros. $15 an hour. Wow. I got $15 an hour for standing down and going, fuck, being violent and all this shit. You're being led by the fucking ear and the ring in your fucking nose. Wake up to your fucking self. Rich, pricks do shit like this, right? Now, do you notice when you guys are getting arrested, nothing happens to Soros? Oh, it will eventually when he gets busted, right? But the whole thing is, you idiots are fucking being led down the road for fucking paper money that's fucking worthless. You need to wake the fuck up. Stop being a fucking idiot, right? I may have been put here by the fucking Mandela effect, but I can tell you fucking now. If you believe that he was born in a fucking America with the amount of evidence that's out there, you're a fucking idiot. If you're being led around the nose by fucking the mainstream fucking media has been proven to be the real fake fucking news. They've been fake news for fucking years, okay? You're 16, 17 years old. Well, guess what? I'm 50 fucking three. I've seen this shit fucking happen. I was a protester once in my life until I woke the fuck up. Right? I found out they were lying to us the whole fucking time. I haven't, and I can tell you now, I started losing faith in the media most probably when I was about 20. There was some real news still coming out for a little while, but about 20 years ago, something major fucking happened with the press. It turned into nothing more than a propaganda fucking machine. Nothing more. See, in our country, Labor's the people's power. Right? They were fucking rubbished and they've stopped unions in our country and everything like that. And they've used the power, and I bet you, George fucking Soros is most probably fucking behind it. They derailed one of our fucking prime ministers. Right? Because he upset fucking America. Gough Whitlam was ripped out of fucking power by the Liberal Party. See, the Liberal Party here in Australia is what you would call the DNC in America. Right? We've got our own DNC here. We've got our own fucking troubles. We've got no fucking freedom. They've already... They've taken the guns off everybody in Australia, so, yeah, they had a big recall, they took all the guns, and they used a fake thing. Again, same thing as in America. Oh, it was a mentally disturbed kid that somehow managed to get guns. See, they're just playing you the same way they fucking played us. Look at Australia's history, and you're going to find that that's what you're going through fucking now. See, Australia was the test case. And they're now trying to use that all over the world because it worked in Australia. So they're now trying to use it on you. And they're doing false flag after false flag because you guys are too tough. So wake the fuck up, for God's sake. Right, you need to impeach your current president. The moment he's out of fucking power, make sure the prick goes to jail. Right? Make sure that fucking Chelsea Clinton doesn't get into fucking power, because Chelsea Clinton will be influenced by her mother and her father, right? Look into the history of their family. Look into what's called Pizzagate. You're going to get a big fucking shock. And trust me, there's a shitload of evidence out there. There's even a video out there that proves this fucking pizza restaurant where they've all visited is all about paedophilia. Look at it. Find out. Anyhow, you need to wake up, America. And I mean, you need to wake the fuck up. Share this video. Like and subscribe, please. And if you're a subscriber that's a Hillary crybaby, personally, I don't care. Just wake up before you drive yourselves into the ground. And I can tell you now, the DNC's planning something. Trust me, we're hearing about it. Do you know in Australia, we constantly, like Hillary should have won, all this. Like, we're still being lied to, but the smart ones here know not to watch the fucking news. Right? Kids still fucking watch it because, like, the kids get told by the school teacher, oh, you got to watch the news. See, teaching here is all about fucking indoctrinating you to follow the rules. That's what it is. That's why school is mandatory. That's why homeschooling is not. Right? Homeschooling in some countries now is illegal. Germany, they just jailed a family and took their kids away. They had to fight to get their kids back. Look at history. Right? Don't look at the news history. You will find occasionally a couple of stories in there of what's happened, people being locked up. Now look at, actually, there's a good one. Kanye West. All right? Kanye West has just been fucking locked up, right, for backing Donald Trump. Right, he's been fucking locked up because he stood up and spoken about Donald Trump. And they locked him up in a fucking mental institution. Wake the fuck up. You got something really fucking wrong going off in your country. Right? And they're claiming stations like this one. I'm just going to turn the sound out so when I pop a channel, it doesn't go blurting out. There's stuff like the Next News Network. You got Fox News is even being called a fake news channel. And there's so many out there that they're all claiming that they're fake fucking news and they're all bullshit. Like this one here, this David fucking Pac-Man show, right? He's a fucking fake news channel, I can tell you now, because he's fucking all about Hillary. And you got to wake up to your fucking self, folks. You got to look at everything, look at the big fucking picture, and you will find out. You will find out that there's a lot of fake fucking news out there. Yes, I know that some fucking news people are orientated to one candidate. Yes, I know that. That's always been the way. But they don't put out, like these little ones, like I watch this guy, and then I look at where he's getting his research, and then I look at their research, and then I find out where they got their research, because this is how you do research. You backtrack other people's research, find out if the information that they've got was real, right? And you say, okay, yeah, is the thing. And you look at it. See, Obama, puppet of the fucking New World Order. He is. Obama really is a puppet of the fucking New World Order. You've got to wake up to your fucking selves, folks, in America. You got a major fucking problem. You really fucking have. And the New World Order has been ruling you for too fucking long. Like, go out and look at everything. Find the news for your fucking selves, right? Cry baby fucking protesters. Look, right? And in this, right, when you look at this, you'll find that, yes, there's even teachers amongst these kids. Right, just trust me, and I bet you it was the teachers that fucking spurred on everything that's going on. So wake up, folks. Right, you need to wake the fuck up. Right, these kids are being influenced. Right, they're told that Hillary's the best and everything like that. This is at the impressionable age. Teachers should not be allowed to impose these feelings on kids. Because you get one kid to do something, right? And the way it works in fucking high school, right? It works the same all over the fucking world, right? You get the popular kid to follow you. If you can get your popular kid to follow you, his cronies are going to follow them. They're going to see, oh, the popular kids are doing it. I've got to do it. Whether or not they fucking believe it or not, the popular kids are doing it. And that's how they're controlling the kids. And I bet you 10 to 1 they've paid the popular kids to do it first. And the popular kids said, oh, if you do this, well, you're going to get paid $15 an hour. Not all we're going to do is walk out of class. We get a day off school. And 10 to 1 the teachers are still be on. And they're even backing up. Yeah, it's real. You get paid $15-$20 an hour. They're most probably getting paid $50 a fucking hour for getting the kids to fucking do it. Right, that's why you look at all these, right? Yeah. A teen Trump supporter beaten. Just go through the fucking news story. You don't have to fucking watch the news story, right? There's plenty of fucking different things out there where it is out there. And I mean, everything is out there. Everything will tell you the same fucking thing. Right? Everybody, look at the shit. Right? This guy is being accused of being a fake news channel. Right? Everything Alex Jones puts out, right? If Alex Jones puts a video out, right? What Alex Jones does, he puts the links to everything. He puts the links to where he gets the fucking information. And you can go through and you can look at it. He'll tell you where he gets his fucking information from. See? These are all, and you've got different things. Fair enough. Alex, it's everybody, oh, but he sells stuff. You know why Alex Jones sells stuff? Alex Jones is a self-funded channel. Right? Here we go. Kanye West kidnapped, held by government. I've actually looked at his speech. Do you know that his manager came up while he was making the speech, started taking off his sound gear, and he walked off fucking stage the moment he knew he was being cut off. All he was saying that you were being conned. And Kanye West gets fucking locked up and held for fucking psychiatric review. Right? Because he's downgraded a few fucking celebrities. And guess what? Oh, that happens to you when you do it on YouTube too. If you downgrade a celebrity on YouTube, you get barred. So, yeah, look. All he did was endorse Trump and he gets fucking locked up. Right, here's the actual fucking, there's a video, not the actual video of the thing, but it's part of it. Right, and all he does, he gets up on his little stage and he backs Trump. So because he's backing Trump and not the popular kids, Hillary's not even fucking popular. Right, the mainstream media said Donald Trump is now losing everything like that. Guess what? I did my, when they kept on saying that he was losing and everything like that, I looked into the polls and he wasn't losing. But the strange thing is, you know, those polls that they put out and everything are just someone getting on a fucking phone and ringing somebody up and saying, who do you support? Who do you think is going to win? And I'll say Hillary or Donald Trump. But do you know they're biased, right? They'll ring up X amount of voters. It's the same as, like, I was once rung up a couple of times, actually, but I kept on saying, Labor, you got to vote Labor. And they stopped fucking ringing me because I kept on saying Labor. So, and I haven't had a phone call in most probably 10 years. But I used to always get a fucking phone call, but I said Labor. But now, because of all this orientation and everything that's going on, they fucking don't ring me anymore because I always say fucking Labor. But to lock a celebrity up because he backed a presidential candidate, this proves that you're being controlled. Wake the fuck up. See, we don't wear tinfoil hats, but you guys certainly wear fucking earmuffs on your fucking head because you're allowing these fuckers to tell you that, like, the bullshit, and they go out and they tell you, right? Everybody says, oh, no, don't watch YouTube. It's full of shit. You want to know there's more truth on fucking YouTube than there is in any fucking newspaper. And dead set, right? I really do only use newspapers for my puppy dogs to shit on because that's all news is good for. For puppies to turn around and take a dump on. And that's what you should do. Take a dump on the mainstream fucking media. Stop listening to them. Stop fucking watching them. And don't, any ad that goes on while the mainstream fucking news is going on, ring them up and say, oh, look, if you advertise on the fucking news, I'm not buying your product. Right? Because that'll tell the advertisers, and maybe then the mainstream media will realise we're fucking woken up. And they can't control us anymore. This is why they're trying to shut the internet down. It's because they know that we're getting the real truth. Because we're able to find the information for our fucking selves. And learn that this is what really happened. That's what really happened. It's the same as this, right? This is from one of the... He's not so much a... I wouldn't call him a fake news thing. He just repeats everybody else's news. Calls himself breaking news live. He doesn't really present a story. He just steals a video and puts it out there. But see, here, he's saying in Portland, 21st of the 11th, 2016. Right? This actual riot there, because I know that fire, happened the day after the election. And this guy, see, I think this is a mainstream media funded channel, because it just seems to be reporting and rehashing all the old fucking news and everything like that. But yeah, I've seen like these fucking protests, and they say peaceful protest, smash, smash, smash.
Peaceful protest, smash, smash, smash. Peaceful protest, smash, smash, smash.
Well, guess what, protesters? If you think that's a peaceful fucking protest, that's actually in life called a fucking riot. That's not a peaceful protest. You may as well just say, riot, riot, riot. And then maybe the cops will do something about it. You've got to remember, half of them are being paid by the governments, paid by their fucking leaders, and they're told not to do anything. Because if they do shit against their fucking CO's fucking will, they lose their fucking jobs. So they can't really fucking speak out. Even if they don't support fucking Hillary, they're stuck and they have to fucking do it. So wake up yourselves, America. You've got a major problem there. And, I mean, wake the fuck up.